What's up, Facebook, YouTube? Tonight's topics, I have about eight of them. Let's start with the most popular trending activity. Mayweather versus Manny Pacquiao. Now, I've heard so many different reviews. I actually stayed up and watched the press conference after the match. I've heard a lot of people, even some neighbors down the street, ordered it. They weren't too happy. There were a bunch of people over there. Apparently, there was not that big match everyone expected. A lot of people would say that Mayweather just did it for the money. He also bragged about the fact that he had $25 or $50 million given to him before he even showed up to the building. So, my opinion to that is it more about the money or is it for the sport? To me, it's just about the money. Because you're not going there and you're not doing what you're supposed to. You want to run around. From what I've heard, he was running around the ring, holding, blocking. He wasn't doing what a normal boxer would do. He was just doing the half-ass boxing moves. So he said in his press conference that he thanks his faith and his people that are surrounding him and all that. You know, you hand him $200 million, you give him $200 million a fight. Of course, I'll say anything in the world to make me look good. I'm not saying that he's not a talented fighter, but he waited to face this man because, of course, you get older, different sports, your age really makes your body fall apart, as in like in wrestling. But he waited so long to fight Manny, and you know Manny went in there and he said he had a good match. He thought he fought a good match. Again, money talks and the bullshit goes out the door. Because you pay me $70 million, I'm going to say, yeah, the other guy, yeah, we had a good match, whatever. Give me my $50 million, I'm going to walk out the door. Okay? People paid almost over $100, probably after taxes, $105 for a pay-per-view. And for what? De Hoya tweeted out last night at the conference that Manny won the match. And pretty much Mayweather won the bragging rights. And that you can look that up on YouTube because it was on the press conference. It was a good press conference. Mayweather does not do a good job of staying in one spot. He was too busy doing a bunch of stuff at one time while doing the press conference. His own manager or father couldn't even say what his next match is going to be in September or exactly what his future is. But he kept bragging the fact that when you have all this money, there's nothing left for me to do. Well, in that case, if you have all that money, you got nothing else to do, once you go out and support your community or do something with it, it makes you look like a better person instead of beating people up or your wife or your child or whatever the rumors going around with that. Prime example, Mike Tyson. On topic two, I want to talk about speed. I will be posting a video of this. I was going down Furnace Ranch Road in a sports bike. Looked like a Yamaha. Was literally about 3 inches, 4 inches away from a 60s, I think it was a 66 or 68 Mustang that just left Popeyes. And I was behind him. And this car, this motorcycle just slid between me and him and then went going on Route 10 on the right, making a right. And it went this close. And I caught it on video. I'll be posting it on YouTube. Please check that out. It was really bad. That was almost something you really didn't want to catch. I was just filming the car because it was really nice looking. Another thing is that give me your opinions and comments on this, but how many people speed past you or cut in front of you on the highway and on the small side roads? You know, the speed limit is 30, you got the ones that go 15, and you got the ones that go 60 or 70. They're trying to go around you. Have you ever felt My question is to you tonight is, have you felt like you just want to step on your brakes and just teach a person a lesson? Because I know that maybe that could run through everyone's mind. Topic 3. Topic 4. I took my stepchild to Lake Waterford. Anybody around the Pasadena, Glenmarnie, Severn Park area knows what Lake Waterford is. It was originally owned by regular everyday people that owned the property and stuff, was man-made. And then the county came in and, of course, like any government, screws everything up. A couple weeks ago, I was up there with my wife, and we got told by some prissy guy, the bread's bad for the ducks. Okay, you know what? There's stuff that's bad for us, too. But people have been giving them birds bread for years. And he had enough cousins to come up to me and tell me, hey, you're gonna harm the ducks like that. Who are you? You know, are you some activist person who really believes in that? No, I got nothing against the activists, but it's just that when they cross that line of knowing that's their opinion and forcing it upon you is where you kind of cross that line. And parents today, you know, in their 20s or in their 30s, are really afraid of their kids getting sick. And I've noticed this because when Lake Waterford had a wooden park, I got splinters in my feet, I got splinters in my skin, and I'm sure many boys and girls did at the same time at that age, when they were a little kid. Busted knees, I mean, you were a kid. You know, you put a little Neosporin in, a little Band-Aid, you cleaned it out, put a Band-Aid on it, you were good the next day. Nowadays, people think there's more germs. No, there's not more germs, okay? It's always been the same germs. They just try to make it, the media tries to make it something bigger than what it is, when it's the same shit we had to go through when we were kids. Now they want you to give your kid antibiotics that don't work, that do more, that slow down the immune system, which causes why a child gets sick faster than if you put some Neosporin in it, and a Band-Aid, you're good. Okay, now they want to give you a solution to everything. And most of the antibiotics don't do nothing. If you don't let your child's immune system get immune to the sicknesses and stuff, it's never going to be the same. I'm not saying I'm a professional, but I've asked, you know, practitioners, I've asked I've asked doctors who've been, you know, doing medicine and stuff like that for years. I actually saw a doctor who was practicing for over 50 years, and he said that if he didn't, he had a choice, he wouldn't do what he was doing. He would rather give them people earthly treatments that are good for the human body and not some kind of man-made crap that you get now that really doesn't do anything. On sports news, on the second part of sports news, on topic 5, Dale Earnhardt Jr., as everyone knows, number 88, he won the race today. He stayed in the lead for about 50-some laps. It was about that, somewhere in there. There was a couple accidents today. Jeff Gordon was in one of them. I always call Jimmy Johnson the golden boy of NASCAR because I'm not taking away from him. He's a talented driver, but I don't say I personally like him. Professionally, I don't, because he's the golden boy child of NASCAR. And if he goes away from NASCAR, NASCAR is shut down. LOL, it's a joke. But Earnhardt deserved it today. He won. I was really happy for him. So all the Earnhardt fans, you did good today. Tonight around 6:30, I went to Greenway Bowl. Great Bowling Alley, they updated it a lot. A lot of people say, well, what's that got to do with anything? Because a true bowler doesn't bitch and complain about the lanes. This is the second time I've been to Greenway in 2 years. The last time I went up there, almost three years ago, actually, I bowled a 740, which was like in my top 10 700 sets. A lot of people to that 700 sets don't mean nothing to me. It means a lot when I do it because I know that I still got talent in bowling. So I bowled I went up to today at my Aunt Chris. Aunt Chrissy sent me some free passes. I went up there. I bowled a 224, 226, and then I ended up bowling a 300. Of course, it's unofficial. I don't get recognized for it, but I got congratulations for a ring of people, which was kind of, was really awesome. It was my third 300 and my second highest 700 set, 750. Each time I go in a bowl now, I think I don't have it anymore. But every time, I amaze myself knowing that I can still do it. Let's see. Bowling prices and bowling alleys. Now, if you're a regular person, you don't go to bowling leagues, you don't go into the bowling alley three or four times a week or twice a week, whatever. And you just go there to have rock and bowl, you go in there and have fun, just to go with the family. Your first game at Bowl America on a Saturday, or after a Wednesday or Thursday, is going to be $5.45 a game, and that's not even including the shoes, which is $4.40, which is, the shoes are pieces of shit anyway. I've stood there and watched customers walk in and walk out because I gotta spend $10 before I even throw the ball down the lane. And he said, we can go down the road and spend less than that and get shoes and a bowling game. That money could buy food and everything. So that's Bowl America Glen Burnie. If I suggest go somewhere else, I gotta get familiar with more of the bowling alley prices around the area. The Greenway was $2.50 a game, which ain't bad for a Sunday. I was really ecstatic about that because Bowl America is always over greedy high. And that's not due to the employees. There are some great employees there. I'm not going to mention names, but they know who they are. And they do a good job. Unfortunately, they don't get recognized for what they do to for that bowling alley. And that's very unfortunate because they give their lives to the bowling alley too. And, you know, some people need to retire. But again, there's some good people there. They do their job, but they get pretty much told no, that when they come up with ideas to make the business more money, Bowl America Corporate comes in there and says, oh no, there's a guy named Alex, I believe. He's an ass, okay? He's a typical corporate person. And what I mean by that is that he does not know what goes on in that bowling alley. If I had lots of money, I would buy that bowling alley and remodel it and make it into what it's supposed to be. Bowl America's like USBC. It's ripping its bowlers off and screwing the game and the sport of bowling up. Many people are USB sanctioned, which is basically pay $20 every year for a membership. They took away awards. They sponsor a lot of different things for cancer patients and people with young people and people with disabilities, physical disabilities. And I'm all for that. I'm all for helping those people. But there's the point of that's just the propaganda behind it. They don't care about bowling. Because they should recognize the people who actually bust their ass and try to get a 700 or 800, and they don't. A 700 towel, you bowl a 700 towel, you get an award, it takes you 6 months to a year to get that towel. Really, how hard is the print on the towel? Send it to the damn address. UPS it. But they're greedy. They don't care about the bowlers. To all my bowling friends out there and partners, I'd like to see your comments and thoughts about that. Anyway, have a good night. Please like and comment and share. And hit me up. Thank you.